Hello, it's good to see you. And today I have another mini drugstore unboxing. Now, originally I just wanted to get one thing from this collection, but I ended up getting three things, if I'm not mistaken. I don't know why this box is so big. I just wanted to show you how big this box is. It's like two of my hands. I don't know why it's that big. I could have fit in a box that was this size, but I guess they only have this size of a box. And maybe bigger, but I feel like this is their smallest box. Because when I get something from DM, then it's always in this box, and it's always a way too big of a box for what I actually got. But whatever. I'm going to open this up. I do love those boxes though, with the different bottle designs. So there's a fly. I do love those boxes. But I'm going to open it up and put the box to the side, and I'll take the items out and we're just gonna look at them one by one. So yeah, my voice is still messed up. I hope that you don't mind. But anyway, let's get started. Okay, I just wanted to show you. The inside is just packed with paper and there's nothing in here. Oh well, it looks like there's nothing in here. It's just empty space. Oh, but it says öffnen und genießen. Open and enjoy. And auspacken und wohlfühlen. Pack out? Unpack. Unpack and feel nice. Wohlfühlen. Do you also have the issue that if you speak two languages, that you cannot really translate them because they are kind of run, like they run separately in your brain? Because I've had that for quite a few years now, that I have issues translating stuff, but I don't have when I'm talking. So like if I wanted to say Wolfen in English in a sentence, I would be able to do it, but right now I cannot remember the word because I've seen it in German, so like my brain is dead. Yeah, okay. I don't know. I do have a couple of friends who say they have the same issue, that translating is not possible or not easy to do. But maybe we're the odd ones and that's not normal. Anyway, I'll put this to the side and then we'll get started for real now. Okay, now inside there is a paper bag with the product, and even here you can see that the paper bag looks empty because there's just two things inside. And there's another thing that was on the outside of the paper bag. So we start with this one. Now, I got it because I thought it looked cute, and I do know that the color works with my hair, so yeah. But it's part of the Essence Bloom Light collection. In the Bloom Light. You can see it here. And the other two products are from In the Blue Light as well. Now, if you don't know what Essence is, it's a cheap makeup brand, a cheap makeup brand that is definitely in multiple countries in Europe. I don't know if it's all over Europe or just Central Europe, I don't know. But I do know that other countries have it as well. And it's affordable, cheap makeup that isn't too bad in quality. I've shown you a couple products before as well from Essence, like the jelly nail polish that I've worn a couple of times now in videos. So yeah. But I do really like these velvety scrunchies, because I do need this exact stuff to keep my hair up. I cannot use I do have one over here. Oh, it's a bit dusty. Okay. I cannot just use these hair ties. I do have to secure them with another hair tie. Now, what I usually like to do is I first put my hair in one of these hair ties, just a normal hair tie, to make sure that I don't have any bumps in my ponytail, because I feel like when you put these ones in without having secured the hair first, their texture likes to pull on some hair and then create bumps on the top of your head, like where you pull the hair together, you have these little bumps and ridges. And I don't like that, so I usually put them together with this one first, and then on top of it I put a velvet scrunchie to hold it in place. Now this one has... Can I just... Yes. Now this one has some little ears on top. Now, I do see that on camera it looks blue. It is not blue. It is green, actually. It's green. It's full on green. I don't know why it currently looks blue in the camera, but it's actually green. It's like a dark, very rich green, you know, those typical... Well, it's a type of green that you always see with velvet products, you know. Yeah. I think it looks blue because of my purple background. I don't see any other reason, but that's probably it. So the other two products are also from the same collection. They are in here. Kleine Produkte, große Freude. Little products, big fun. I don't know, big joy? Joy, yes, it's joy. Überraschung. Anyway. Yeah. 100% recycling paper. Wow. I don't know why they color it brown, though. Like, if you have recycling paper, then the color is gray. So they are actually coloring this paper. And, I mean, it does have the little black dots and stuff that recycled paper usually has, but I'm not sure I believe them, actually. Because, again, recycled paper is always gray, so they make it brown on purpose. Which is weird. Like, why would you do that? To make it seem more green? I don't know. Yeah, it's just some really weird marketing techniques that I don't get. you know, newspapers are usually recycled. They are grey with lots of black and white spots everywhere. You know what I mean? I forgot it's three things. It's not two things at all. It's three things. Now, the first thing that I've pulled out, wait. Okay. Is this lip gloss, shiny lip gloss. Isn't the packaging just so beautiful with like those flowers and bloom in the bloom light and those flowers on here? It's really hard to see, but it's so pretty. Now it is a shiny lip gloss and I think it's tinted. Well, it is tinted, obviously, but you never know what color you get with lip gloss. Okay, so it's a tiny, tiny little bit pink, but not really. And it smells just like your typical sweet lip gloss smells. I don't know. A bit like flowers, but just a typical lip gloss smell, you know what I mean. I hate these sounds, actually, that lip gloss makes. It's so disgusting. Anyway, some people like it. And the color is Moonlight Glow. Oh, it's so moody. It's giving... Okay, this is really weird to do in almost silent. Okay, now these are all lip products, by the way. They are three the lip products that these things have. Okay, so the next one is the In the Bloom Light Matte Lip Liner in the color Live in Full Bloom. Now, originally I thought that they all wear the same color, which is why I got them. I only realized at the end that they are not all the same color, but I do hope they complement each other enough to still be able to use them together. But I really like how moody everything looks like. I feel like they nailed that. So here we have it. Okay. It's a dark red color, I feel like. Let's take a look. Oh, it's purple. Never mind, it's purple. Look at that. Oh, this is gorgeous. I thought it was going to be like a red. Well, it is kind of reddish. It's a reddish, purplish color thing. But it does complement the lip gloss well. So at least you can wear the lip gloss over it. Maybe they are the same color, because I know that the third product is purple, or supposed to be purple. I haven't tested it out, but maybe they do complement each other after all. They are just all called different. But let's see. Now this, and also it's very smooth, like the application is very, very smooth, which is always nice. Because when you have to press too much, then you have to sorry, my voice. You have to pull at the lips too much. I feel like this happens a lot with eyeliners that are in this kind of way, like where you have a pencil eyeliner. I feel like many of them are just too hard to put on, and so you have to pull a lot and you get an uneven result. At least I do. Usually you can blow on them. Well, not really blow, but you know what I mean, to make them more warm and manageable, but sometimes that isn't working either. Now for the last thing and the main event, which was originally the only thing I wanted to get. It's the lipstick. It's the lipstick also from In the Bloom Light, and it's a satin lipstick, which is always important for me because I only wear satin and, well, glossy kind of lipsticks. I do not wear matte because matte lipsticks just feel drying to me, like they dry out my lips, and I don't like it. But this is in the shade Kissing at Midnight. Now it is made from cardboard, which I don't mind. I have a lot of stuff made from cardboard. I do prefer plastic because I'm always a little scared that I will break it. But I don't mind paper either. I do get that they're trying to look more sustainable by using cardboard, even though most of the time that is not the case at all. But whatever, I don't know what these companies are thinking, and I don't care. But oh, it's all shiny. Oh no, it's broken. That is very disappointing. It is completely and utterly broken. Look at that. Can just take it out. Okay, I'm gonna have to return this one. That is disappointing, but the color is nice. Yeah, see it all. It all complements each other. A nice color, but okay, that never happened to me before. But you can tell me whatever you want. It's because they always use those big packets, big packaging for these tiny products. This is really disappointing, but can you see this color and this color to complement each other? They are the same color, kind of. This one seems to be a bit darker. Which makes sense. But I did wanted to show you the lipsticks because it's so pretty. But now it's all broken. Maybe I can still show you though. It's got this beautiful flower design around it. Can you see that even? I have to be careful how I hold it because it's just gonna fall out again. So it's very pretty, but unfortunately, it's very broken. I'm so disappointed. And I bet I can't even get a new one because. Okay, anyway. Now, this is in no. This is not this packaging's fault. Because you can see it is not damaged at all. I honestly don't know how this happened. Maybe the lipstick is too short. And then it got like. hobbled up and down a lot or something, I'm not sure. But anyway, I will return this lipstick and hope that maybe I can get another one. If not, I don't think I mind it all that much because I have the lip liner, and the lip liner is almost the same color. So yeah, this was the one I wanted to get. This was what I was excited about, and it is broken. It probably got broken in transit. Very disappointing. But it had to happen eventually, didn't it? So yeah. Anyway. We have this beautiful green, a hair tie, and the very pretty lip gloss, and the very pretty lip liner, and the unfortunately broken lipstick. But I do really like this collection, and I like the colors, which is why I got it. I didn't know what this one looked like, and so I just thought they were all the same color, and they are, thankfully. So yeah, I was a bit confused because the names of the shades were different, and then I got kind of scared that maybe they're not all this color, but they are, so everything's fine. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this little haul. I will probably update you at some point if I was able to get a replacement for the lipstick, or if I just got my money back at least. Okay, I'm just gonna cut in right here because I've got some good news. I went to a different store. I went to Rossmann and I've got one. This was the last one that they had. It was actually cheaper. It was only €2.20 instead of €2.75, so it's really cheap. I think I mentioned that Essence is very cheap, but I don't think that I actually mentioned how much they cost. So it was either €2.70 or €2.75, I'm not sure, or €2.79, not sure, but very cheap. But yeah. Now this one, look, oh, you can barely even make it out. It's kind of, oh, it looks a little bit like a mess. Like you do need to focus when looking at it to see that it's supposed to be flowers. But it is, it's supposed to be flowers. Oh, awesome. You can see, I don't know if you can. Well, anyway, so this is not as pristine anymore at the tip because I did swatch it already. So the other one was really shiny, and this one originally as well. But it's not anymore. And just gonna swatch it on my hand real quick. Ooh, look at that. And also I can't get it, like it stains, which is amazing. It's not like a full-on stain, but it's quite hard to get off the skin again. So what I usually do when I have lipsticks is I put on some lip balm, and then I put on a bit of lipstick, and I just, you know, mix it together on my lips by smacking them and everything to get a lighter color, like this. And that's usually what I do. Okay, so lovely color. Wait, I'm going to swatch the Do tell me. Wait, I'll just go get it. The word I was looking for is lip liner. Because it is the same color, or like almost. Well, it is actually the same color. So yeah. We have... So, it's exactly as I thought. The colors may have different names because this one is called Live in Full Bloom, right here. Live in Full Bloom. And this one is called Kisses at Midnight, but it's the same color, or almost the same color anyway. So I don't know what I'm gonna do with this one. This is the broken one. Because it doesn't really... There's no point in trying to get my money back because it's not even 3 euros, right? So like, whatever. I did ask if they can get me a replacement, but it was sold all out already. And I haven't gotten an email back. Because they did say they were gonna send me an email, but so far I haven't gotten one. And now I don't need a replacement. So I think maybe I'm going to try and smash it into a little container. But I'm not sure what I'm gonna do. But while I was there, I also saw something that I... from the same collection that I did not want to get originally, but when I saw it I was like, well, you know, the color's kind of nice, so obviously I bought it. Now this is a duo eyeshadow, and it's Dreaming in the Twilight. My voice is still a little rough. Dreaming in the Twilight is the shade name. And we have a glittery, well, not a shimmery one on here. That kind of reminds me like the Skin of a Killer. And I'm guessing a matte one skin color over here. So let's just swatch it. I am not here for the matte color, I am here for the shimmer, obviously, but let's go with the matte first. Well, it does look like skin. Like, very light, a little bit... Can I blend it in with my skin? I don't think I can. Because it is like red, it has a red undertone, and I am green. But can I? Well, I don't know what I'm trying to do. So it's basically my skin tone, but with a red undertone instead of green. Or some, I don't really know. I think it's green or yellow. Or my skin is kind of sick looking. But yeah. On the camera, it does look more like skin color than in real life, though. It is definitely too pink to be an actual skin color. It looks like a very, very slight sunburn, maybe. Or like pink, you know, the pink color, like a very, very light pink, like a pink. So I'm not sure about that, but I feel like you could use it as a layering on top if you want to layer something else on there. I'm not sure. But this is why I got it. So the other side was why I did not want to get it originally, and... This is why I got it after all. Okay. Do you see that? Okay. Okay, it is glittery a little bit. It's mostly a shimmer, but it does also glitter a little bit. So yeah. Oh, it's beautiful. It's a gold, copper kind of color. Maybe also not. I'm not sure. No, I feel like it's copper. I was thinking rose gold for a second, but there may be some in it, but it looks kind of like copper. And it's very pretty. I know my skin is maybe not the best to show off these colors, but well, yeah. So this one does dry matte. But it also kind of dries out the skin, which isn't really a problem on my eyelids. I don't know, I never feel it on eyelids, but I do feel it on my hand and on my lips. But never on eyelids. I can wear matte ones there. But anyway, this is what I... Oh, look at that. Oh, here you can see it better. Anyway, this is all I wanted to show you. So I did get my lipstick after all, which is great because I do love the color. But yeah, oh, I really like this glitter. I love it. Anyway, now we are finished with this video and I do hope you have a good night's rest. And I hope to see you in the next video, and sleep tight and dream of many little delights. Until next time, bye!